I'm a misandrist. I'm a feminazi. I'm a communist. I have an Oedipus complex. I must be really, really, really fucking evil.
Transgender person, male to female.
You're gonna hate me.
I'm afraid of the day when I will get beaten up by Philadelphia police.
Right now.
This is the life of ADF.
Christian, ADF. Two Lolcows, both alike in dignity. Both trolled and had their lives chronicled by the internet because of their own outrageous actions.
For the purpose of fairness, I will be referring to both Christian and ADF by female pronouns, as both of them currently identify as women, even if this makes some of Chris's statements quite ironic.
Out of the long history of trolling and manipulating Chris, included a troll who went by the alias of Jack Thaddeus. He, amongst many other things, was notable for hacking into Chris's PSN network accounts and blackmailing her to do outrageous things.
It's okay to be gay, let's rejoice with the boys in a gay way.
Such as humping her PlayStation.
Damn you, Jack Thaddeus, give me back my PlayStation Network account. I'm so damn stupid. I got a goddamn motherfucking 6-inch cock with 4-inch diameter balls.
He also hacked into her Yahoo account and bought homoerotic ads on Chris's wiki page. ADF herself had also tried to troll Christian, even though she had experienced similar situations herself. She said that trolling Chris is okay because Christian is homophobic. Her past trolling included redrawing characters from Sonichou, as mentioned in previous parts, by posting a screenshot of her high score in the Kick the Autistic Picto game, by posting a photograph of an Xbox 360 with the caption Hexbark X60, and posting a photograph of a jar of pickles with the caption For Sonichou, in reference to Chris's pickle man troll and hatred of pickles, and calling Chris the most sexist man in America. However, none of these events ever got any kind of response from Chris herself. Chris completely ignored ADF's existence until one day she logged onto a webpage called Tomboys and Tomgirls of Virginia, a page that, little known to her, was secretly ran by trolls, who tricked Chris by claiming they had the identity of all Chris's past trolls, and encouraged Chris to threaten to dox them with details that they provided Chris with.
When it got to Jack Thaddeus, the trolls gave Chris ADF's details to make a video on her, claiming that ADF was the real person behind the Jack Thaddeus persona. Chris made this video in drag, something she was experimenting with at the time, and to mock ADF for being transgender.
Good day. I felt it was appropriate to dress in my feminine attire as you can see fit. Because I am definitely calling out one Jack Thaddeus, and we happen to share similar common interests, a few of which. We both accept the adjective of being called trannies, except for him, he's just going through the whole gender changing operation. Yeah, swapping off his dick and putting on the old and getting it tucked in. I would never do that. Never have a sex change operation. I'm proud to be a male, and I'm even more proud to be a tom girl. And we both like to cross dress, yes. And we both are into femdom, which is female domination. Oh yeah. I'd like to get smacked by my woman. Except for, I would definitely put against Monsieur Jack, or his real name as it is said in the title of this video, which I will say in a moment. In his case of him having his operations and going through it, I feel that he would definitely not be considered any at all a woman whatsoever. He just only fashionably looks like a woman with the parts and whatnot, except he does not have, except he would not have a uterus. And he would have no reproductive organs. I mean, I want to have children someday. Obviously, he don't. And also my associate that gave me the information on him, he pretty much just pointed out calling him a Tom girl. But you know what? He's not a Tom girl at all. He's just a full-blown gay. Anyway, get back on the topic. His name is Ahuviya, which it is spelled in the title of this video. He is in Pennsylvania, and I have pretty much just gave a few descriptions of him. He definitely appreciates his homosexual culture as it is. I mean, yeah, everybody who is a homophobe, go ahead and call him on it. Call Ahuviya a goddamn homo.
Homo. Ahuviya, I'm a homo. You can't get hurt. Blah, 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 blah.
But, of course, my demands are simple, as they have been recently. I want Mr. Ahuviya to make the public apologies for all the things he has done against me. Shoot, I forgot to write them down. But he knows what he did. Among which, he has pestered me and on the phone and blackmailed me to do a few things. Yeah, I'll get those stats and if he does, and I might add them into the description of this video after I write it down. Anyway, 25-year-old Ahuviya, homo. We do agree on being cross-dressers. Although I must also admit, I should have access to photo. Actually, yeah, I can't do that. Just zoom in. I only want to put up a free sample for this, as usual. I gotta get a little close here because I don't have zoom in functions on the cross media bar photo viewer. Get close to the television. Yeah. Anyway, he just does a terrible job in quote unquote cross dressing, because I mean, look at that stubble on his face. And then look at me all over. I take the time to shave myself. Smooth. So yeah, Ahuviya, make your apology video, leave the internet, leave me, my family, and my friends at peace. You have, let me see, 1, 2, 3, you have till the 10th of September of this year to upload your video of apology for all the wrongs you have done to me, which I will list in the description a little later. Good day.
Because of this video, many casual viewers still believe that ADF was the real Jack Thaddeus, which was obviously not the case. The confusion was made worse by the fact that the wiki and many of the trolls used ADF's face to represent Jack Thaddeus and always referred to Thaddeus' actions as if they were ADF's.
In response to this, ADF wrote a DeviantArt post saying, "What on Satan's green earth? CWC called me out? Christian Weston Chandler, aka Christian, last night made a video about me. Wow, my name sure gets around. About damn time. I am a real force for good in this world. When America's top misogynist, slash sexist, slash homophobic, slash transphobic, cross-dressing autistic man-child is butthurt by my mere existence. A transgender woman named Chairwoman Ahuviya Harel of Philadelphia, PA. No, Chris, I am not making you a video apologising to your white privilege, materialistic, fat ass. You deserve no sympathy from me. I am putting my own life in my own hands and shaping my own destiny. And will continue to transition to the woman I am without apology and without shame. I worked and sacrificed immensely to be able to realise who I really am, and I remind myself of it every day. Something you will never aspire to do. Work and sacrifice for a greater good. I have lots of friends here in Philadelphia who support me and my decision to transition genders. In return, I give back to the LGBT community through volunteering and activism. Again, something you do not do. Give back to a community. Lastly, I am not Jack Thaddeus. I do not waste time hacking people's PS3s. Materialistic garbage. Work harder to get to me. Make more videos calling me out and bashing transgender and gender variant people. See what happens. Hell, maybe this is the start of another saga. Harel versus CWC. Bring it, bitch. Long live Chairwoman Ahuviya Harel. Long live the People's Democratic Republic of Philadelphia. Long live the queer dictatorship of the proletariat. For ADF's birthday this year, she received mace and a hunting knife. She claimed these weapons were for her own personal protection. She also posted the lyrics to a rap song she wrote, titled Ahuviya Hell. And could anyone actually like rap or sing? I want to produce some of these songs, she writes some more later. So hit me up, I'm going to make ADF music after this. Chris did not receive a response from ADF, so she posted another video revealing more information.
Hello again, the internet. I have heard that I have not seen any response from Mr. Jack Thaddeus, as Aussie is known as Ahuviya. So therefore, I will reveal a little bit more information about him, starting with another portion of the photograph. And let's see, what else do I have here on the stats? He was definitely responsible for hacking the network accounts. Probably had a hand in that blackout a few months ago. And he blackmailed me into humping my console. And he said to be disgusting ads on the Wikipedia. As well as so there's trolling schemes within the past couple of years. Let's see. Oh yes. He is a communist! And we do not like communists within this country! We are Republican, Democrat, or neutral. And I am neutral, so I can go either way. But I do not exactly care much for communism! We do not like to stand under one ruler. It is very unruly and stupid. I will give a Heil! Heil! Right in the Fuhrer's face. Heil! Heil! Right in the Fuhrer's face. Oh yes, he is also a big fan of bondage, sadoism, machoism, and disciplinary fetishes. And he is in the process of a sexual change. He is going to have his wiener chopped off. I would never do that. Which I believe I mentioned earlier, that is the one thing in being a tranny that I disagree on with him. And he's definitely never going to be a female, truly. in that sense, in female dominance. He has to get a real woman to come in order to do that. He still lives in Pennsylvania. Still a homo. 25 years old. Ahuviya! Stay tuned.
In response to this video, she wrote, CWC, he vans to take on the Soviet Union, da! Der Führer Chandler of Nazi Germ, I mean Quickville. At it again. Zeke fail! Making fun of Chris for mistaking communism with Nazis. Eventually, ADF did make a response video, speaking in a calm and collective manner, giving Chris advice and dismissing the allegations.
Hello, Christian Wisham Chandler. This is Ahuviya Harel from Philadelphia, PA. It came to attention that you made a video about me, criticizing my and hundreds of thousands of other people's decision to transition gender. I'm going to have to tell you this pretty much straight. I'm not going to apologize to you and your family for your stupidity, for your ignorance, because you just don't deserve it from me. Chris, my decision to transition gender was not done in like one day. It has been nearly 10 years of debate. 10 years I struggled to figure out who I really am. And, you know, I tried, you know, being male for, you know, the better part of 24 years, and, you know what, it didn't work. It just didn't work in the end. You know, you keep trying and keep trying. You end up just keep spinning out, worn out wheels in the end. So, I said to myself, you know what? I want to I need to transition. This is needed. If I'm going to be able to be happy for the rest of my life. You know, I'm still early in the transition. I mean, I've only been on estrogen for a year now, and right now I don't really look like I, or sound like even, I pass as either gender. And that's okay, Chris. And I'm happy. I'm happy. I'm happy to be Ahuviya Harel. You, however, you're not happy being yourself. You can't be yourself. You keep being locked into this idea that, you know, it's the straight, heteronormative, male-female binary way you have to live, or it's no way at all. Let me tell you something. As someone who's a male-to-female transgender and who is pansexual, this means, Chris, I love everyone regardless of their gender identity. Gay, straight, bi, trans. I love everyone. That's something you are incapable of doing. Because you have shown the world you are incapable of tolerating these differences. You know, I am not repressed in areas of sexuality and gender, whereas you are if you continue your thinking that way. So, I don't know what to tell you, other than you need to change really, really bad. And thousands before me have said this. And you need to go out and see the world. And you need to leave Rutgersville, Charlottesville. You need to come here to Philadelphia and see how people are like here. And, you know, you need to get out of your room. That's all I gotta tell you. you need to get a job, you need to get out of your room, you need to see the world. And that's it. I had at the beginning of this said to myself, should I even make a video to you? Do you even deserve a response from me? I decided in the end to make a response, not because I wanted to get back at you for insulting me on YouTube or anything, but you know what? I'm making a response to you because I actually feel sorry for you more than anything else, because you're just incapable of learning to be tolerant of lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender people. And I feel, so long as, you know, until in this country, I won't be fired for being transgender or for my sexuality in any of these 50 states, I will make it my job to fight for LGBT rights. Simple as that. Until, you know, two women or two men can love each other, can get married in all 50 states, I will continue to make it my job to fight for marriage equality. Equality in the workplace. To be able to have the same privileges as heterosexual married couples. And until pay is equal between men and women, women still make 78 cents to every dollar a man makes. This is what you don't understand if you are a white male and privileged in this country. And you just need to know that. This transition, I do this for me because I want to be happy. I don't care what you think, what anyone thinks, what my town thinks, what my family thinks. I do what is best for me. I do what makes me happy. Hell, I had to leave a job of 8.5 years just so I can be happy and be able to transition. Sure, I may have taken some missteps early on, whatever. I don't give a shit. But guess what? I am Ahuviya Harel. I am happy who I am. Chris, freedom is what you make it to be. Until you get out of that room, get a job, get your own place, see the world, you don't have it. And one last thing, I believe all people are equal. Now, I'm a socialist. Communist, actually, but, you know. I am, you know, I just believe all human beings are equal. And speaking to someone who still continues to not see that, it's my job to reach out to you and say these things to you and say, you need to get out of your parents' house, you need to get over your autism, you need to find a job. This is common sense I'm giving to you. You do what you want with it. More than likely, you aren't going to do anything with it, but whatever. I don't care. And you know what? Weren't you expecting me in a dress or something like that? I want to tell you something, hon. I'll dress whatever I want right now. If I want to wear a blouse tomorrow, I'll wear a blouse tomorrow. If I want to wear a camo today, guess what? I'm wearing it today. You know, welcome to the 21st century, not the 11th century your damn Christian Bible teaches. And your damn church, you know, and your parents still extol the values of. Change is going to come to your world, and you're going to have to learn how to adapt. And my only fear is you are just totally incapable of doing that. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.
It seems that ADF was one of the few people able to understand Chris. And ironically, a few years after this, Chris did come out as both transgender and bisexual. The same day, she also made this video insulting Chris.
Hey everyone, Harel here, Chairwoman Harel to be exact. You don't know who that is. Why are you watching? Anyhow, I'm with a friend. We're doing a photo run this evening, you know, catching sunsets and shit. We're not on a PS3 drawing furry comics like Christian Wisdom Chandler does. So, we're having a good time in this beautiful city of Philadelphia. Fuck Charlottesville, fuck Rutgersville, fuck Quickville.
Fuck CVC3.
Yeah, them too. Yeah, TVCC. Mary Lee Walsh.
Yeah, Mary Lee Walsh and Michael Snyder.
Actually, Snyder's a good guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, at least keeps Chris Ben hammered from the fucking store, so. Yes. Snyder's a local hero here in Philadelphia for being a good manager.
Yeah, there's a street named after him.
Yeah, it's in South Philadelphia. It's Snyder Avenue. So, I'll leave you with that moment of zen and enjoy your evening while we catch these beautiful sunsets that just lie down the street.
Chris responded to these, clarifying her thoughts on homosexuality and how she doesn't want to be forced into it.
This is my video response to Ahuviya, who has apparently taken it upon himself to record his response without wearing his face optionally or leaving it out. So I'm just going to respond directly with a few of my own thoughts. First off, I am heterosexual. I am straight. That's just the way I am. It's not a have-to situation. I've rarely seen it that way. I have at one point, but guess what? I've seen the other viewpoints, and they did not fare to me so much. They mostly grossly amount. Therefore, that is what I am, and I am happy to stay that way, and I want to continue to be heterosexual. I am happy with myself there. And I will admit that with other people, there are differences that I feel most uncomfortable about and around, such as, yes, gays. Well, gay men, anyway. I like lesbians. Smokers? Definitely the smokers. Can anybody tell me why smoking isn't stupid? I don't think so. And just most other males and gender, in general, because I get along better with women anyway. That's not really my fault, that's just part of my dang brain function with the missing links in my brain and whatever. But that does not define me as an uncaring and cold-hearted person. I have empathy. I can put myself in other people's shoes and see how they would feel if my responses into whatever situations. And yet while you may or may not have empathy as well, Ahuviya, I feel you to still be a typical non-understanding pig. I would travel outside of the state or wherever if I could, but because A, I am on low funds, and I would get a job, but unfortunately, because of all the shit that's against me on the internet, between the hate-filled web pages that y'all trolls and cyberbullies have created against me, and the past videos that I was blackmailed and deceit and just plain forced into creating with such derogatory graphic smut and literal shit within them, it just makes it that much more difficult for me to be able to get a job, because they do the background checks, they look on Facebook, they look on YouTube, they look everywhere. They don't just do criminal records anymore, ask anybody. And I would travel if I could, but my parents are both old. My father is
ill. He's sickly. He has feet bloatings. And he has ailments that doctors are unable to determine. And at this point, he's now certified as a forced shut-in. He cannot get out so much because he feels so ill and sickly in his feet. And I do get out of my house. I go out here and there and everywhere. So don't tell me that I don't get out. Listen, I want you to listen to me here. I am all for equality, but there is a limit. I do not want to be forced or intimidated into or bullied into lifestyles that I just not am of or feel comfortable around. And if this was a country where people would not feel forced to do anything, then whatever. And yes, marriage should be between two happy people, regardless of gender or whatever. But I'm still gonna feel most uncomfortable around homosexual dudes, regardless. So I would say, good luck being a fake woman, because you'll never be able to achieve true femdom, and you'll always be a dang homosexual male because you were born that way. You're gonna stay that way pretty much, even if you're gonna have your dick either chopped off or tucked in. People are still gonna look at you so ill in the majority of this country. Anyway, that's my response for now. Damn homo.
ADF also posted a video titled "Why Philadelphia is so much greater than Quickville."
Hey Chris, have a look at this. You're gonna hate me. Welcome to Philadelphia, where it's okay to be queer.
An avid viewer of these videos set up a YouTube channel called Australatina Archive, posting earlier content and updating it with every time ADF uploads.
During this time, she became in contact with a man named Trey Pepe, who had watched these videos and decided to pursue a friendship with ADF. Little did ADF know that Trey was also part of the forums, and eventually considered this an act of betrayal. At this time, she had recently made her Facebook page private, paranoid about trolls seeing what she posted. However, these trolls had access to the accounts of people very close to ADF, including Maria. ADF also appeared in a couple of Rika's videos. On the 4th of September, ADF claimed that she changed her birthday to May 9th, the day she got her name change, and that all her family would honour that. She also wrote a post claiming to have been attacked by hyper-heterosexual African Americans. They see Ahuviya Harel riding Scepter equals this. I was attacked this afternoon riding on Scepter 23 bus at 9th and York. Transphobic African-American North Philly kids thought it would be nice to fire their basketball at my window. The window broke, but didn't shatter. I am not physically injured from the incident, just shaken a bit. Note to North Philly thugs, next time, use a gun to kill me if you hate transgender people so badly. On September 6th, Chris's father, Robert Chandler, passed away. While many of these trolls respected this, and decided to back off from trolling Chris, ADF continued her brigade against Chris Chan.
Christian Wish and Chandler. I'm certain you know who this is, so I will save you the introduction. I heard about what happened to your father a few days ago. I'm sorry for your loss. but it's not to say I didn't warn you about it in any shape or form, because I've been kind of telling you to change your life, and this has kind of fallen on deaf ears, and I expect this video to do the same. You're gonna, you know, choose to ignore it, and very much continue the status quo with your materialism, your PS3, and your mom's hoarding. I really think that it's time for me to just simply make a personal appeal to you to change your ways. And if you continue to resist, I'm gonna make it my business to ensure I'm gonna be warning your ass from this point forward. Chris, I just want to clarify something. I did not hack your PlayStation Network accounts. Jack Thaddeus doesn't exist. He's a Free Realms character, so for you to even believe the guy exists, you're very foolish. You let yourself get fooled again and again and again. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. Fool yourself a third time, you're just retarded. I propose for you to move out of your mom's place now. I know that's all you've known. And I know it's scary moving out and being in the real world. But guess what? You have little options left. You don't have your dad anymore. So, I don't know what to tell you, man. A bit of real quantitative change would do you good right now. And I don't know what to tell you, because once upon a time, I used to be really not being able to take care of myself, doing foolish things, and, well, I don't know what to tell you, but you're gonna have to change something today. I mean, I managed to change something. I did my 180. I saw the world with new eyes. I think you can do the same too. It's just nobody's pushing you. Nobody in that house is pushing you. So I'm gonna make it my job to push you. So, I don't know what else to tell you at this point. Other than that, your mom's next to go. That's all I gotta tell you, and she's morbidly obese, just like you. Hence why they call, hence the trolls, why they call you, your mom, the Snorlax. Just too fucking big and overweight. So, I propose an entirely different way of going about your life. And I think you'll benefit from it in the long run. So, hear me out. Chris, give up your material possessions. You don't know what it is to lose everything. And quite frankly, until you're ready to put everything on the table and lose everything, you haven't lived a life worth living. Oh, I also propose one more thing for you. And you're definitely gonna hate me after I propose it. This will save you. It saved me.
It will come to save you. Communism for the win, baby. This is Ahuviya Harel making it her business to tell you you need to change your life.
All of this turned more attention on ADF from Christian followers. Trolls like Forg were convinced that this meant all their attention from trolling Chris should now go to trolling ADF.
This led to users such as Intro Man contacting and conducting an interview with ADF's father. A couple days before this, ADF made a now deleted, very insensitive, self-centered post on 9/11, making the day about her abuse and volunteer work that she had done. Trey and a couple of other trolls joined this call.
Let's start this bitch. I'm gonna be the typing medium for Angelo, since he's old. Let's get these questions started. Not too impressed with ADF? Angelo hinted that ADF's doing great by living by himself. Philip took a lot of work to be sociable and independent. Philip has said all over Facebook that you raped him, did you? Angelo is dismissing the rape allegations by ADF. He's saying that Jackie lied to Philip, and Philip having his disability made him believe that. How often do you get to see ADF? And do you fully support the choices he's made, e.g. transitioning, etc.? Angelo sees ADF once a year at the most. Also, Ange thinks this is just a phase in ADF's life, stating that him being a queen means he dresses up as cartoons. Angelo pretty much called ADF a homosexual queen who dresses weird, but in a nice, subtle way. So what he's saying is that ADF believes what he does because the mother put the idea in him? Sounds like a fierce divorce. Yes, and the fact that Philip has a mental disorder. What did your son want to be as a kid? Angelo honestly doesn't remember what Philip wanted as a kid. Exactly what's he doing now? There was some talk that Angelo's homeless or something? Angelo is not homeless. He has a new family. ADF doesn't like the fact that Angelo hands around minorities. So the son is a bit of a bigot. Angelo does confirm that Philip does have some prejudices in him. Does Angelo have any fond memories of ADF? Whether it be growing up or in more recent times. Angelo had a hard time raising Philip because of his disorder. He also remembers Philip's most recent house arrival. Angelo still has trouble acknowledging the Ahuviya alter ego. Tried to explain it to him, but he still thinks ADF is a homosexual crossdresser. Okay guys, gonna take a 5 minute break and log on to Maria Popo's account to show Angelo ADF's Facebook. Be back soon. Logged on and hit ADF's Facebook. Angelo actually thought ADF's Facebook profile picture is of a Nazi and is slightly mad. Oh damn. Had to explain to him it's a Russian cosplay or something. Okay, I scrolled down ADF's page and ADF put his education as Moscow University of Engineering. Jello doesn't understand how ADF could do both Moscow and GCC. And is talking about how ADF's mother is bad with money. To be able to send ADF to a school like that and be on social security? Understandably so. Does ADF have any connection to Russia at all? Has he ever left the US? Not at all, unless you're counting having a Russian email provider. I pried out my homie Jello that he and Jackie used to drink heavy till the second trimester, which explains a lot. So Ahuviya does have FAS. So I showed Jello some of ADF's friends. I don't want to give this crazy bitch any publicity. Let's just say she writes really horrendously and is a communist. Jello saw her profile and is wondering why the FBI hasn't arrested her for being a traitor.
I showed the blue colour pencil sentence about being raped on 7/4/1997. Angelo actually said he spanked ADF for trying to abuse an 8-year-old at a gathering.
Wait, abuse an 8-year-old? ADF tried to rape someone? sexual or physical. At 8? What kind of abuse we talking? Whoa, push around the 8-year-old, nothing sexual. That's a relief. With ADF, you never know. Actually, as one of my Hermanis, Maria, can tell you, ADF likes the underage bishies. I told Angelo that ADF is dating a 16-year-old online, and this is the maddest I've seen him. What does Angelo think of that? Does he know? He knows, and he is honestly pissed off. He wants the trolls to call the 16-year-old parents' house and tell them the news.
We would if we could. I have the parents' phone number.
Just too lazy to buy Skype credits.
Is Angelo alright, considering he just found out his son is dating a 16-year-old? He's telling me funny stories of Jackie hijinks, like trying to make Philip even more retarded on paper so she could get benefits out of him, or letting him stay in high school 2 years longer than usual. Angelo is still pissed, but I told him we will take care of this.
One, what does his father think of his political stances? And two, are the stories of him hitting his mother true? And has this happened more than once? He thinks that his son's stances are temporary, and they will change over time. ADF used to be a Republican in high school. Actually, Angelo said that ADF used physical violence when she tried to abuse his disability diagnosis. So he hit his mother? Yes. Because she was exploiting his disabilities for monetary gain? Yes. Any other conflicts transpire between Philip and Jackie? Just minor teenage drama. Like spending ADF's SSI check and stuff of that nature. I've got a couple of questions if they haven't been asked. Did ADF cross-dress or show any behaviour that was out of the ordinary? He said that ADF was a normal, straight male until he noticed that his relationship with Corrine failed and his son came out. Angelo doesn't know that Corrine wasn't his girlfriend. That would explain a lot. What about ADF's previous girlfriends? He didn't have any. It took ADF a long time to get down conversation, hygiene, and confidence down. So no signs of feminine behaviour or girly leanings. Angelo didn't detect anything. Ah, so it's still a possibility, but highly unlikely, since Philip makes shit up so much. Has he seen the screenshot of the Ahuviya Remembrance Day event he deleted? I told him about that event, and he just shrugged it off. He implicitly said that it's more offensive, not to him, but survivors of abuse. Does he know how Phil made the event one day after the 9/11 anniversary, after calling it the result of capitalism? Okay, Angelo has got to go home, so he says thank you for asking him these questions. And to watch Philip, he wouldn't want his son to go to jail.
On September 19th, she wrote a post reading, "I have a problem with misandry. I, Chairwoman Ahuviya Rotem Harel, confess the following I have been either lying, burying, and or have denied. I could lose friends over this, but I must come out about it. I hold misandrous views against cisgender men." She then posts the definition of misandry and blames this on a variety of internal factors, starting with her father and her mother's other allegedly abusive boyfriends. She admits this goes against her preaching for equality and her pansexuality. "I am romantically attracted to FTM bishies, and I'm smart enough not to unfairly lump them with the patriarchy system, as they also get shafted by the male-dominated society. I want to change, but it'll take a very long time to fix this problem. I still suffer nightmares and trauma from my sex abuse, and this is a scar I could be trying to heal for the rest of my life." ADF then posted a video recording a fake police call.
"We have,
okay, who are the son of bitches doing that? I guess it's Ahuviya Harel and..."
"Okay.
probably Haruzumaki or something. God.
She also posts a video firing her friend's cap gun at a shooting range.
Hi, this is Chairwoman Ahuviya Harel, and I'm going to be test firing the Mosin Nagant pistol.
This is a very old service pistol. Goes back to 150 years of service. Served very well with Soviet police, and I'm going to fire it off. And this will stop cold any transphobic people.
Male pronouns are punishable by death. Hold on.
On the 28th of September, she found out about the phone call with her father, and in response stated, "I am cutting any and all ties with him, as per his participation in the cyberbullying efforts against me. My decision is final. I am a horrible misandrist feminazi. Whatever. Fucker deserves to die and have his dick cut off." In early October, Occupy Philadelphia started, a large collection of non-violent protests to combat economic inequality, corporate greed, and the influence and corporations of lobbyists on the government. It was known that ADF would attend, so she was followed, filmed, and interviewed during this protest with multiple people.
"Why are you carrying the Chinese flag?"
Little did she know, she would eventually become the straw man of that movement, being given attention by mainstream media.